Hi everyone, I'm Connie Roberts.
And I'm Jim Skokoza.
Welcome to Pocono Landscape Challenge.
We're here and we're underway at our private paradise project, and we're going to show you all about it coming up next.
Jim, there's a lot going on with these plants.
Yeah, it's a big project. So we've got multiple things going on here. A lot of paving, different various paving. We've got a large grill island. We've got a pool house going up. We've got a fire pit. We've got benches. We've got a waterfall going into the pool. And of course, a lot of planting too. So we're very excited to get underway. You can see we've already begun the project here. We're going to be here for a little bit. It's more than a week, and it's going to be very exciting to see how this all comes together. Homeowners are very excited as well.
It's definitely a private paradise here.
It's going to be when we're done, yeah.
I see you got a wall going up, Jim. I guess it's to protect the pool.
Well, that's part of it. I mean, you can see as many of our projects, we have a lot of grade issues, okay? So we have all this slope coming down this way. The pool was set at a specific level so that the rest of the project comes together the way we wanted to, and we didn't want the slope coming down into the pool. So we're putting up this retaining wall, and it's got a nice flow to it, as you can see. And it's gonna be about 4 foot high maximum height here, grade off in the back. That's gonna be lawn on the top. Eventually, the entire area will be fenced in. But what that did for us was to give us some space to do some interesting things here. So one of the things that we're going to do is over in that area there is we're going to build a rock waterfall that's going to fall into the pool.
Nice.
So we've got our plumbing already in. We poured a concrete foundation for that. And right now we're just letting, the concrete was just recently poured for the pool here. So we're letting that cure for a while before we do that part of the project. There's going to be elevation behind here. It's kind of like a planting berm that'll blend in with the rocks behind the pool. And of course, a lot of planting and a path that comes over to the rail going into the pool. And then the rest of this all gets paved. Over on the right-hand side here in the corner where you see that pile of stone, that's going to be a large sitting bench with a 6 by 6 foot fire pit, a very large fire pit, because they want to sit out here at night and enjoy the fire pit. And then we have some paving that connects to the rest of the house. And then over in that area, if we want to take a walk down there, we could do that. Okay, so Connie, we got multiple things going on here all one time, as you can see. So this is all the pool equipment here. This whole area is a 14 by 24 pool house that's going to get constructed, okay?
Ooh, nice.
What these are, we poured some piers. This is going to support the concrete floor. This section here is going to be a bathhouse, so it's going to have, it's already rough plumbed in. So we have plumbing and electrical and all that kind of stuff right here in the bathhouse. And then the other side of this, from here over to the rest of the 24 foot, this is all gonna be an outdoor paved space with a roof overhead.
Nice.
So you can get out of the sun a little bit, sit underneath, have a couple dining tables under here, have the bathhouse right next door to it. So a lot of the work has already been done. As you can see, there's a lot of trenches that were dug, so there's all underground pipes and drains, gas lines, all that's been pre-done before we started our project here. Behind you is where our grill island's gonna go. So the top of this concrete deck is gonna get have pavers on them. And then you're gonna be able to sit at table height, 30 inches here, and there's gonna be a bar here, and then it's gonna be one step down into this grilling area, and one more step out. So this grill is gonna come across and then come across like this. Eventually they wanna put some kind of a roof or maybe like a tiki hut or something over the top. But we're gonna build that grill island here. So one of the things we're gonna be doing next is we gotta pour the foundation for the grill island. Right behind you, here's our water lines. We're gonna have hot and cold water because there's gonna be a sink in there, drain line, gas line, and electric lines all coming into the grill island.
Wow.
So a lot of planning. Yeah. We've been doing planning this for a while.
Nice.
Yeah.
Work now begins on the grill island.
Jim, the grill island is on its way. It's looking good.
Yeah, we're just getting started on this here now. You can see we have our concrete foundation or a footer in there. We've got all our gas line, electric line, drain lines for the sink, and the water lines, hot and cold, coming in already, all set up. And this is kind of the tricky part because we've got a lot of fitting to do. We've got to put in all the elements in the grill island. So at this point, it's just kind of a little bit of a slow process because there's just a lot of details to work out. But in the end, that's what makes a great project.
Jim, what is Bruce doing right now?
Well, that's our transit, okay? And a transit is our best friend because it keeps everything on the up and up here. We make sure we have everything level, and we make sure we're working with all the proper grades in here so that we're shedding water where we need to shed. So the transit has given us a reading as to whether we need to move up or down based on the current grade there. And it's, again, it's a very important part of the work that we do, and we're using it all the time, constantly.
Can't do it without it.
No.
The next feature to be built is the fire pit. In a few days, most of it is done.
So this is pretty big. Is this a sandbox for the kids?
It's a sandbox for the kids. Now, this is actually going to be the fire pit, okay? And it's pretty large. It's about 6 foot square, as you can see. And it's at the right height now. What we're doing is we're having a custom firebox made up here out of steel, which will drop in here. We have caps on top of this, and the firebox will drop in there. So you can build a pretty darn good fire on that. And then behind us, we did this custom bench, as you can see here, which is really nice. It makes it nice for comfortable, with plenty of room to put down some cushions, you know, to make it nice and cozy that way. And on the back side here, we're building a backrest. We haven't installed that yet.
Okay.
And of course, we also included, because you want to have a cold beer or a cold water or something while you're sitting at the fire, so we've got a nice drop-in ice chest right here.
Oh, that's
so
cool. It even has a drain. Of everything.
Makes it really convenient. So it's going to be a great spot. You can sit here, fire pit, have a refreshment, go back and jump in the pool. You know, again, it's going to be a paradise.
Coming up next, work begins on the outdoor grill island. First Northern Bank and Trust is your local loan specialist for both personal and business needs. Our local decision makers offer fast approvals and customized financial solutions, helping you reach your goals. First Northern Bank and Trust combines friendly service with the latest technologies to make banking quick, easy, and convenient. We continue to grow in Carbon, Lehigh, Monroe, and Northampton counties. Serving you with 11 local branches, First Northern Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender. And now, a message from R.J. Groner.
UV light system, ultraviolet light or ultraviolet germicidal lights, which are designed to kill the bacteria, the viruses, the molds, the things that are in your airstream that you're breathing every day. So especially when you're locked in the summer because it's hot and you're running your air conditioning, or in the wintertime, you want a way to filter and clean that air. So these products that are on the market nowadays are fantastic at doing that job and relatively affordable.
Whether it's an installation or emergency repair, call us at 570-421-7260.
Sonia's Sweet Inspirations will help you blow your guests away with elegant cakes, cute cupcakes, specialty desserts, and more. Reader's Choice Award winner for Best Wedding Cakes. Sonia's sweets are just that, sweet. Stop by North 9th Street, Stroudsburg, to try a new fresh dessert today. So come by to Sonia's Sweet Inspirations at North 9th Street, Stroudsburg. Check us out at soniassweetinspirations.com and follow us on Facebook.
Connie, we're standing in what eventually is going to be the grill island, you know, a little center of attention right here. Any questions so far?
Well, where is everything?
Remember, it's a process, okay? So last time we showed you how we had the concrete footer, and then we were going to build up from there. And what we wanted to do is make sure we made all the accommodations for the particular products that were going into this. So we have an outdoor refrigerator, which is going in this space, okay? We have here is where the grill is going to be, okay?
Nice.
This is a set of access doors and some drawers. And over here is going to be a side burner.
Nice.
Okay. So once the homeowner still has to determine what he's going to do for granite on the top. And the granite gets installed, it gets cut out, it comes out, they come out and template everything. They cut the granite and install it, then we'll finish putting in some of the pieces. Because over here as well, We have an under-counter sink here as well with hot and cold water.
Oh, nice.
So we need to have the granite in place before we can actually finish a lot of the work. So the basics are done. You can see we have some boxes in here for electrical work. This would be so if you want to plug in a blender. Interior-wise, we have a box that will plug in for the refrigerator.
Mm-hmm. What's this here?
Okay, that's a good question. So that's a grill. So this is a propane-fired grill. Okay, it's coming off a 1,000-gallon propane tank as a direct feed. So anytime you have propane in a small space like this, or a confined space, it needs venting. So we put this grill here, and there's another one over on the other side, so we have air circulation through there to vent any gases that may be in that space.
Okay.
Good question.
Jim, what's up with the vacuum?
I like that, huh?
I didn't know you could put the slabs on those blocks on top of this concrete.
Well, a couple things. So this is a great handy tool that we work with here. These paver slabs, and they're called slabs because of the size, the dimension of them. Once they get over a certain size, they're called slabs, not pavers. But they weigh about 120 pounds a piece. So, you know, it's a little difficult for two guys to pick those up and also fit it in and drop it into the right space. So this tool really benefits them quite a bit. So it's a vacuum system where it'll literally suck up the paver, they can carry it over, as you see, and just put it in place, which is
nice.
Great.
Yeah.
So, you know, often we have an area where people will have a concrete slab, whether it's a porch or a patio or whatever, and the concrete's in really good shape, and there's no reason to take it out. And the other thing that we have going on here for us is that there was ample room from the surface of the concrete to the threshold of the door that we could get a regular size depth paver, which is 2 3/8, which is what those slabs are.
Nice.
But the proper way to do this, because there's always going to be a little deviation in the concrete surface, and we want to make sure everything is nice and level. Now we do have natural pitch going away from the house, which is really great. But what we do is we'll put down this soil separation fabric first, then we lay down a real thin layer of sand, and that allows us to get a nice smooth finish on the surface and take out whatever deviations are in the concrete.
Oh, nice.
Okay, so it works out really well. Plus, it helps with any kind of drainage issues. When water gets in here, it can get down to that sand and run off. Now, what happens on the border is, as you see, we're using a contrasting color down there to give it a little accent, because we're similarly using that color in a bunch of other areas as well.
Mm-hmm.
But that gets glued to the concrete.
Okay.
And we'll show you that detail a little later on how that happens. So that secures the whole surface,
mm-hmm.
but the rest of this is basically floating on the concrete and that layer of sand. So it really works out well.
Nice. So are you going to have a step then?
On the outside, there is a step down before you get down to the final grade on the pavers. Yep.
Jim, I see you have all kinds of wiring.
Yep.
I guess it's for lighting.
It's for the lighting, yeah, it is. So this is our power source coming over to this area. We have all our power for our lighting in this section coming through this line here. Now what happens is that gets connected to this. This is the lighting that's all underneath the lip of the step going all the way around.
Mm-hmm.
So that'll all be lit up at night and illuminated so that you're not tripping over any of the steps there, okay? We're also gonna be running some wiring up above. This is a two-story deck up here that's gonna be out of the bedroom, the upstairs bedroom. We're going to have some lights in the ceiling that are going to shine down on the patio below. So we've had to kind of run all our wiring prior to us finishing the work here so we can hide everything and you don't even know it's there.
The heavier slabs are moved with heavy equipment, like the step behind the grill island.
Jim, I see that Grill Island is almost finished.
Almost ready for a party, right?
I know, I'd like to come.
Not quite, but we're getting there. As you can see, we've got our granite installed here now. It's a beautiful piece of granite.
Oh my God, it's my favorite.
And yeah, it's all coming together. I mean, we've got our side burner here. We got our four burner grill here. We've got some storage underneath and some drawers. Over here is gonna be a hot and cold sink.
Mm-hmm.
And here we have our refrigerator. So we have to piece a few things together. We've got some customizing work to do. And then we do all our hookups, and then this will be complete and ready to start firing up and having a party.
Cook some steaks. Jim, last time we were here, there was no rocks here.
Right. Well, now it's just a big pile of rocks. No, actually, it's a big pile of rocks as a waterfall. So we've kind of put this together slowly. We brought in some boulders, and we tried to make a water feature that's going to splash down into the pool. Now, we've had it running a little. We've got to do a little tweaking. We have to finish up some mortaring work. We have some lights in here, which are all set to go. And as we build up this area, because this all gets graded, this gets quite a bit of soil back here, and this is all planted. And then there's gonna be a step and a walk coming through there so you can get to the other side of the pool from this section of the patio.
Jim, sometimes I don't see the final vision, and sure, everything just seems to be coming together here. This really is impressive.
Yeah, well, I mean, especially in a project like this, we've got so many elements, and it's such a large scale. It's a little tough even for the homeowner to really envision how this is all going to come together. And again, this is what we try to do right from the beginning when we do the design. So in my mind, I always see the completed project, but it's not always easy to translate to the homeowner or others looking on board until you really start to see. So what happens now, as we've gotten a lot of the major elements done, we've got the wall done, we've got the large patio here finished, we've almost finished up with the water feature, now we're starting to pave the space, okay? Mm-hmm. And so all of a sudden it's like, oh, now I get it. Now it's all coming together as a unit.
Yeah, the grass is coming in beautifully.
Yeah, how about that? I mean, we had some rain over the weekend and some sunshine, and now it's beautiful.
Sure is.
Up next, we listen to the sounds of outdoor speakers.
Isn't it time for you to start enjoying your backyard just like you see in the magazines and on TV? Hi, I'm Jim Skokoza from Chestnut Hill Nursery, and we're here to help. For over 40 years, we've been creating beautiful landscapes for folks just like you. You can count on us to build it right the first time and create a long-lasting project that'll provide a lifetime of memories. Imagine a new patio, fire pit, or outdoor kitchen. Then complete the scene with amazing outdoor audio and lighting. Together, we can dream it, design it, and our expert team can build it. So go to chnursery.com. Make this the season you turn those dreams into reality. Start planning that first party now.
Sonia's Sweet Inspirations will help you blow your guests away with elegant cakes, cute cupcakes, specialty desserts, and more. Reader's Choice Award winner for Best Wedding Cakes. Sonia's sweets are just that, sweet. Stop by North 9th Street, Stroudsburg to try a new fresh dessert today. So come by to Sonia's Sweet Inspirations at North 9th Street, Stroudsburg. Check us out at soniassweetinspirations.com and follow us on Facebook.
Listen, we're in for a real good treat today, okay? We have a special guest here on site. This is Kevin Minton. Kevin, good to see you.
Hey, Jim, good to see
you. Kevin's from Coastal Source. Now, Coastal Source is the company that we use for all our lighting, and you've seen us feature that on the show a number of times already, and we're doing a lot of that in this particular project as well. But they also make a complete line of audio products that are built for outdoors. So, Kevin, can you tell us a little bit more about the product itself?
Sure. Coastal Source originated down in the Florida Keys, where some of the elements are very, very difficult to overcome, and products really take a beating. So the product's built to last in the outdoors, in cold and warm, hot environments.
What about the different size of speakers, or give us some kind of a general range of what we got here?
So we start off with our 8.0 minis, 8-inch cabinet, and we get all the way up to our line source, our line array, which is our flagship speaker, which gives you that concert quality audio. It almost feels like you're at the actual concert.
You know, maybe what we should do is fire a couple of these up and see what we got.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Let's do it. So you got four. Kind of give you that surround sound feeling. Two in the back, two in the front.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Wow, Jim, I remember when this was just a pile of rocks. This looks beautiful.
A little different now at this point, isn't it? Yeah, it really come. This whole project is coming together. As you know, this was really an extended project, mm-hmm. and we've been here for quite a few months over the past year or so. But we had to take a long break because the homeowner had quite a bit of work that they were doing as part of the project. Some of the structures that they put up and some of the other issues that they had to address before we can complete the project. So we're back here now. We've completed some of the planting and we're doing some of the other final touch-up work as well.
Jim, I see the guys are almost done. They're still working.
Well, we're finishing up. We're kind of working our way out of the project here. Mm-hmm. So we're in the final stage where we're doing all the cleanup. We're doing the final steps of the planting in this back end. We're doing the seeding and the lawn work after that, some final grading. And then we just have to go around. We got a kind of a punch list of items, some lighting that we got to tweak a little bit more. But basically, we're kind of at the tail end of this long project, but the end result has just been amazing.
You know? It is beautiful.
Yeah, so when we come back, I really want to take the folks on a tour of this entire project. So.
Okay, stay tuned. We'll be right back.
Still ahead, a final look at this big backyard project.
One of the things that homeowners usually experience in this area is an emergency after normal business hours. Could be a weekend, could be a night, could be the 4th of July, could be Christmas, could be Easter, could be any holiday. You call RJ Groener Company, two things are gonna happen. One, you're gonna get a live person on the phone. Number two, you're gonna get a technician out to your house, 24/7. Go right to our website, rjgroener.com. You can find us on Facebook. You can call or text us at 570-421-7260, where you'll always get a live person to answer your questions. We'll get an appointment scheduled, then we'll get one of our technicians out to you.
Community, it's where we work. It's where we play. It's where you'll find First Northern Bank and Trust, offering community banking services. First Northern Bank and Trust is a family-owned and operated bank. Our local decision makers offer fast approvals and customized financial solutions. Plus, we keep your money right here in the community, stimulating local economic growth and providing jobs for our friends and neighbors. First Northern Bank and Trust, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Some projects take a little longer than others. This one looks beautiful.
It really came out great, and it's nice and green now, too, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, the grass really got green.
Yeah.
Well, everyone, welcome back to the show. This project is complete now.
Well, almost complete. We're going to take a little bit of a tour and kind of show you all the different areas and the different elements we created here and how much the homeowner is just loving the new landscape. So let's take a look.
Okay.
So Connie, this is where it all started. There was originally a large concrete pad here, and this was their dining space. But of course, in the scope of the whole project, we're trying to bring everything together color-wise and style-wise. So we decided to cover the concrete pad with these large pavers that you see here. Now we've used them in other areas, but this is specifically all large pavers. So this is their kitchen dining room here. They come outside here. There's going to be dining facilities out here. And this is their main upper patio. Also above you, if you look up above, there's a deck up there now, which wasn't there originally. The homeowner is actually building that part of the project. And the bedroom is upstairs, and they're going to be able to come out of that door onto the deck, down the spiral stairs, and come into the landscape, which is kind of cool.
Yeah.
So this is basically where all the dining and that type of entertainment will occur. And then if you walk over in here, this is the whole kitchen area. And what you'll notice is when we're standing here, this was built specifically so you could have dining chairs here.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the proper height to be able to sit here and dine and eat at the countertop.
Okay.
And then as we step down and go behind there, everything drops down so everything is the proper level for cooking.
Okay.
So let's take a look at that.
Boy, I love this. I can imagine having so much fun cooking here.
Pretty good, isn't it? So this is where all the magic happens, all right? So what we really did here was create a very large outdoor kitchen. So you can see the countertop is very large.
Beautiful.
Plumbing, this is a sink. It's got hot and cold water in the sink. Mm-hmm. Right behind you here, this is an outdoor range refrigerator, okay? This is a four burner stove. And we also have a side burner as well. So you can really do some heavy duty entertaining out here. And of course, the other thing is that it's under this other structure, which is a pavilion that was installed. And the homeowners wanted to give it a little bit of a tiki look. So there's some, basically looks like a tiki hut from the outside. But underneath here, you're particularly, you're always covered from the elements of the weather. So you can be out here cooking in the rain or some other inclement weather And underneath this hut, again, you can just spend hours and hours out here. But as you come over in here,
this room is
the outdoor bonus room. Yeah, it's not completely finished yet. The homeowner's still working on the building here itself. But this space is gonna be, this wall is gonna be all done in stone.
Nice.
Gonna have a giant TV out here. and then they can also sit out. There'll probably be some deep seating out here next spring. And so they'll be able to sit out here and watch the game. And again, it's covered. It's part of the pool house pavilion that was also one of the structures that went up here. All the pool equipment is on the backside.
Okay.
Inside these doors here is a changing room and a bathroom. There's one other little secret area I'm going to show you back here.
What's that?
We have what's going to be an outdoor shower.
Oh, nice. Well, Jim, I've been on this path before. I'm kind of liking it. It's kind of growing on me.
Looks a little different now that it's all planted up, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's growing nicely.
So this is that little pathway, that little shortcut that we built into the project. But this is kind of a little more of walking through the landscape here instead of just all the hardscape, which is on the other side. So it's a little shortcut through here. You can get to the pool house, get to the shower, and it continues down to the other side of the pool here.
It's kind of fun.
Yeah.
It's
a nice little fun element in here.
Yeah.
And again, we used, as you can see, we put this waterfall together. This is all native stone from the area. Mm-hmm. So we gathered all that up, built the waterfall, so we have that nice sound constantly going on here. We have the hot tub in the pool, which is great. So you can imagine just sitting in here with a nice cocktail and listening to the sound, seeing the sky, watching the lights come on, and enjoying the landscape, quite honestly. Well, Connie, how do you like this?
I love it.
I love the
colors. I love how big it is. It's like its own little
space.
Well,
that's kind of what the idea was, to create all these different spaces in this entire landscape. Mm-hmm. There's a few things left to do. The fencing contractor still has to come in and put up the fence around the perimeter. We just have a temporary fence up right now. The stone has to go on the wall out there. A few odds and ends, but predominantly the project is complete, and you can just sit here and chill and load up the wood and just really enjoy the space. And as you're sitting here, you look out across this beautiful landscape and this beautiful property here in the Poconos. I mean, you know, what's better than this?
I know, I love the Poconos. Yeah.
So, you know, if you've got a project at home, or you're thinking about a project at home, we'd love to talk to you about how we can help you create that beautiful landscape in your own space. Whether it's large or small, it doesn't have to be a grand scale project. Give us a call or look us up on the web at chnursery.com.
Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time, right here.
These plans.
Jim, I see the grill on the island. I know, I'm impressive.
A lot of action, yes.
A lot of action, Jim. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff done. Right here next time. We'll see. right here next time. Oh my God, I forgot my line. I like the little whistle. That means cut.